First of all, I would like to say my sincere welcome to all of you for this wonderful gathering. So today is the third day for Investor Awareness, World Investor Awareness Week. So we are celebrating this continuously this week. So from 5 to October 11, this week will be going to celebrate for World Investor Week. Today is the third day. Today we are associated with Bombay Stock Exchange. So Mr. Badrinarayanan sir will be there for us to take a session today. So he will engage with you. So he is having almost 23 plus years of experience in this financial industry. And then he has 4 NASM certifications with him. He is having sound experience. He has completed more than 150 financial literacy programs in all over India. So he is having well knowledge about financial literacy and financial oriented products. If you have any doubt, you can ask him directly and everything will be clear from now. Sir, Badri sir, the floor is yours.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Sir, it should it be in English or bilingual, sir?
English only, sir.
Only English,
yes,
no
sir,
Tamil.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Vanakkam. Yes. Welcome to this investor awareness program. Bombay Stock Exchange and Zeebu jointly doing this awareness program. We Bombay Stock Exchange, as you know, we are celebrating our 145th year. We started this exchange on 9/7/1875, to be more precise, on July 9, 1875, and this is our 145th year. As a stock exchange, we are the oldest in Asia, Asia's first stock exchange. The main purpose of a stock exchange is to raise funds for the companies which are listed in the exchange. I would like to repeat once again, the main purpose of a stock exchange is to raise capital for the companies which are listed in the exchange. Fixing this as a basic criteria, we at BSE are having more than 5,000 companies listed in the exchange. More than 5,000 companies listed in the exchange, where we can get more liquidity, more number of people to get into the exchange for getting transaction, more companies they have been listed for raising the capital for their betterment of the company. In this annexure, as an exchange, we need to have more clarity and criteria for going ahead in any institution which are being listed. The main or the backbone is the investors who deal in the securities market. As you know that India is the second largest populated country, having 138 crore people approximately. To be more precise, we need to get the numbers. As a small calculation, we will be having as 130 crores. Out of that, only 5% of our population is registered as an investor in our capital market. This 5% is very, very low when compared with the Western or the European countries, so-called developed countries. In Germany, there are around 40 to 50% of the people who have registered themselves directly or indirectly investing in the exchange. In US, there are 60 to 70% of the people of the population who are in US are registered themselves as investors directly or indirectly through stock exchange or mutual funds. Having these as a base, when we compare with these economies, but these are grown economies, developed economies, we are developing nation, and this is our emerging markets. As you know, emerging markets, BRICS countries are the emerging markets: Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. These are all the five countries which are all emerging markets. We stand little bit low when compared to developed countries. We have a registered investors of 5.5 crores investors investing in stock market. Now we shall go inside the presentation. The main purpose of this awareness is like for two types of audience. One, audience type one is, sir, currently I am zero. I don't have any knowledge. So this will be a platform for you to know what is the basic criteria to invest in stock market. Number two, people who have already trading in the exchanges can know what is the updates in the market. With this small thing, we shall go inside this platform, in this presentation, sorry. Just a second. Sir, can you see the screen?
Yes, yes.
Okay. The basic need is, why you need money? This is the basic question that everyone have in their mind. To fulfill the basic needs, we need money. The basic needs are food, cloth, and rent. A place to shelter, food for our survival, and a cloth to cover ourselves. This is the basic need. Some might have seen this in as a Maslow's theory, where this is the basic need, and rising towards our growth is the next criteria. We need to have medical or health insurance, school fees for our children, cinema, vacation, festival expenditure, marriages, parties, and get-togethers. For these, we need money. Source of money. Sir, now we know why we need money. Now, the important is how to get the money sources. One is through earning, like salary, wages, profit, stipend, pension, commission, etc. These are all the various means how we can earn money. And another one is borrow from friends or relatives or getting bank loan, etc. With this source of money, how we are going to implement in our day-to-day life is the major key role. Now we are having money, and this is the source, like earning or borrowing. Now we need to channel this money for our growth. We need to move ahead from the existing place where we stand. Why we need to save money? To buy a car or to buy a house, to have education for our kids, marriage for our kids, and further to have a retired peaceful life. These are all the major and point where we need to save money. Now we will go inside difference between the savings and investment. This is the very, very important item where we need to have our concentration more. Savings is excess of income over expenditure. This is the formula where everyone sticks on to the basic life. Savings is excess of income over expenditure. The income what we earn, we set to spend with our expenditure, and the leftover is being considered as a saving. But this is not a suitable formula where one person want to become rich. Everyone knows that Mr. Warren Buffett, he is the fourth richest person in the world, where he says that income minus savings is equal to expenditure. This is a very good formula where everyone needs to think about it. First one, our income. Next should be our savings. The leftover should be our expenditure. The leftover money which we are having needs to be spent in this manner. So savings need to be invested for generating income or creation wealth or asset. Wherever we go, risk and reward is the relationship in any investment or saving where we are going to park our funds. Next is the power of compounding. How a percentage of money is being calculated and computed for a huge surplus in our coming days. Most important, to beat the inflation, we need to save or invest. Real return creates wealth over long term. Here, real return means the return which we are getting might be 8, 10, 11, 12 according to our investment, minus the inflation is the real return. Inflation, if you keep it as 4 and the return which you are receiving from the investment avenue is 10, and 10 minus 4 is 6. That is the real return. These are all the points that we need to have before investing or saving our money. What are all the things that we need to see before investing or saving? First, capital protection. This is the main point. Very, very important point. Capital protection. I may invest 5,000 or 1,000 or 2,000 according to my capacity, but this 1,000 or 2,000 or 5,000 or 10,000 should come back to me. Next one is the gestation period. How long this 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees or 5,000 rupees will be away from me? Next is the liquidity. Whenever I need money, I should get back it. Next is the rate of return. What will be the return for the amount which I am investing or saving in that? Next is the periodic returns. Will I get the return in monthly, half yearly, quarterly, or annually? These are all the things we need to see before investing or saving in any one of the venues. See, these are all the investment avenues where we can park our money. CHITs, recurring deposit, post office savings, fixed deposits, corporate or third party deposit, gold, silver, real estate. These are all the places where we can park our excess money. Mutual funds, equities. Last but not the least is insurance, where this is a protection and not an investment. These are all the places where we can park our excess money for future growth. As we already seen, risk versus reward. Whatever may be the investment, the risk and the reward plays a major role. Now we are seeing a graph where risk and reward in the extremes. These are all the points which I have plotted, where the risk is less and the return is also less. It is called the money market or government treasuries. Just higher will be the investment in corporate bonds, and above that is our blue chip companies like large cap equities, and up more than that we have small cap companies where the risk is high and the return is also high. But in small cap, we don't know when will the company get in or get out. That is the major throw point which we need to see before investing in small caps. And next is the emerging markets, where I have already informed you BRICS, Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. These are all the five economies where other economies are coming and investing their money into these five economies for their growth. Power of compounding. This is the magic mantra where the investment amount is 10,000, which is being deployed in three avenues where the return is 6%, 8% and 10%. Over a period of time, this 10,000 has grown to 57,000 in investment avenue where the return is 6% and 8% where you get 1 lakh and in 10% return avenue, it is 1.75 lakhs. See, this is the power of compounding where your 10,000 is being getting manifolded. Please keep in your mind that wherever we need investment, the return should be correct and we need to do homework before we need to invest. We need to do our homework because this 10,000 is very, very hard earned money. We need to deploy this amount where we need to get maximum return from the investment. Next is the inflation. This is the very big thief where each and everyone needs to have an eye on this. Here I have taken five daily used products: toothpaste, LPG gas, masala dosa, petrol and movie ticket. These are all the five things which I have taken. In over a period of time, I have taken three times, where in 1980, 2000 and 2020, current rate. Toothpaste at same 50 grams or 100 grams, which was 4 rupees, now it is 80 rupees. LPG gas, it was 30 rupees and in 2000 it was 250 and now it is 660. This 660 is where we get the subsidy from the government. And masala dosa, it was 2 rupees, earlier 20 and now it is 60. And petrol, 8 rupees, 32 rupees and now as of now it is 84 in Chennai. In movie ticket, it was 2 rupees and 50 rupees, now it is 200 rupees. Please see, have a look and have your forecast for the next 20 years, what will be in 2040. This toothpaste currently is 80, might be 200. LPG gas, we might not get gas itself. Masala dosa, currently 60 rupees, might be 140, 150 or 200 something. Petrol, no chance. Sorry sir, we don't have petrol. Gulf countries may come down and saying that, sorry, petrol not available. Movie ticket, currently 200, might be 500 or 1000, we don't know. Please have a look of this and with these as a basic things, we need to start saving or investing. I have taken this, this is the gold rate in, it's a 22 carat and 8 grams, one sovereign gold. See, in 1930, one sovereign was 14 rupees and current it is in the month of August, we were around 40,000. See how the gold rate have moved. The consumption of gold is also getting increased in India. But in India, this is, we as Indians have more priority, have more affection in gold rather than in other investment avenues, equities, mutual funds, etc. Well, gold is also taken or considered as a safe haven. So we turn our investment directly to gold. Government have also started introducing this sovereign gold bonds. which was started in 2015-16, and now we are in almost 43rd tranche, 43 or 44 sovereign gold bond, where Government of India have issued for the retail investors who can participate or start investing in paper gold. In this 2020-2021 series, first tranche was released on April 20th to 24. Per gram it was 4589. The total people invested in this first tranche was 1770 kilograms. Second tranche was May, second week 11 to 15, 4540, and number of kgs was around 2500 kgs. In the month of June, 4677 per gram, and it was 2388 kilograms which people have started investing through SGB. In the fourth tranche, it was in the July, it was 4852, around 4000 kilograms people have invested through sovereign gold bonds. In fifth tranche, it was in the August, and in the sixth tranche, this is the rate where people can buy both in physical and in DMAT. In physical means you can get it through post office, banks, etc. In DMAT you can get it through your broker. This is the sovereign gold bond which Government of India have started issuing through the brokers, banks, post office, etc. We can also invest through this, where we get 2.5% as a return on this 5,667 rupees as a face value. This 2.5, where we can get break of 1.25% for every 6 months. Next is the investment in stock market. How to invest in a stock market is to find a SEBI registered stock broker, where you need to provide your PAN, address proof, bank details and your photo. KYC, you need to fill it up. DMAT and trading account opening form to be filled, and you will be getting the details. Whenever and wherever you fill your KYC and you submit your details, please get the photocopy of the application form before you hand it over to the person. Please enter your valid email ID, mobile number and nominee details. Very, very important is the nominee details. You need to get contract note, statement of accounts from the broker. Change of address, mobile number and nominee should be updated then and there. This is very, very important. Please, any investor or any trader need to update your mobile number, email ID, change of address, nominee, because now you might have seen SEBI have come down with various measures to stop irregular trading, because some of the dealers have placed the orders without the knowledge of investors or the trader, where the traders comes after a week or a month stating that, sir, I don't know how these orders were being got executed in my account. I was not known, I was not updated, I was not given the contract note, etc. But please have yourself updated. If you have any disputes, you need to inform the exchange, inform SEBI as early as possible to get rid of this problem. This is the fundamentals what you need to see before investing in equities. Promoters, the reputation of the promoters and their stake in the company. This is the very, very important, where you need to see who is the promoter of the company, and if this promoter have already been caught down in any other illegal activities performed by him by any regulator. So we need to check before investing in the company, who is the promoter? Is he having any problem or anything? We need to check before investing, because each and every rupee which we are investing is our hard-earned money. Tom, Dick, and Harry, their regulator recommendations, I bought this company. I don't know what is this company, because you are investing your hard-earned money. Please don't go by the hearsay. Next, we need to see the scope, growth, competition, profitability, and the structure of the industry which the company belongs, and position of the company in the industry. Financials, very, very important. Ratios, earning per share, PE, book value. These are all the items which you need to see before starting investing in your, through your SEBI registered broker. Free cash flows, yeah, very, very important for the operations. Past growth record, sales turnover, profitability of the company. We need to have a glance before investing. Dividend payout, this is the very, very important, where a investor expects more number of dividend from the companies which he is investing. Debt of the company, very, 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 very important. See, when you select a company, you need to see whether the company is having debt or not. If it is having debt, before paying the dividend, might be it might earn profit or not, but the company has to pay the interest for the debt which they have received from the creditors. This is very, very important. Next is the corporate governing tax. For each and every quarter, half yearly, annually, they need to publish their growth, sales, etc. They need to do AGM, EGM, minutes, everything has to be recorded. Board meeting, everything has to be done. Company, each and every company that are listed in the exchange has to go by the rules. So each and every company has to track. We need to track the corporate governance of the companies which we are going to invest. Valuation of the company with its peers, very, very important. We need to see the same company, I mean the same industry which the companies are belonging, how this company and how that company is performing. This is just an example. If you take it as an IT sector, we need to see both TCS, Infosys, Wipro, everything. We need to compare, and then only we need to invest, because we invest our hard-earned money. We need to do all our homeworks before investing a single rupee into the stock market. This is just a glance. It's a funnel where we need to see the details before investing. How to select a stock for investment? The same one, promoters of the company, where the promoters should not pledge their shares. Very, very important. Growth, profitability, financials, dividend, debt, corporate governance, valuation with this peers. These are all the filter items where, and the last one will be the your company which you have selected. This is the technical analysis. These are all the small tools where we can see the price movement are plotted in a chart. These are all the various theories where we can have Dow theory, candlestick, Elliott wave theory, moving average, Gann angles, Fibonacci chart, and there are much more technical tools. These are all the tools which as a common person need to have an idea before investing in stock market. This is just a journey of how Sensex moved from 1982 till date. This is the latest update where it is coronavirus had triggered. This is the place. And now we are moving towards 40,000. What are all the products that are available at BSE for an investor? Equity, derivatives, future and option. This is not for investor. This is only for used as an hedging tool for high net worth individuals, please do not go for derivatives if you are a normal layman investor. This is not for investor, this is for HNI, currency derivatives, where you can for the trading in USD INR, GBP INR, Euro INR and JPY INR. These are all the four cross currencies that are being approved by SEBI for trading in currency derivatives, commodity derivatives, gold, silver. Everything are being traded in this commodities. Next comes the interest rate derivatives, debt market bonds, wholesale corporate bonds, everything can be dealt here. Mutual funds or exchange traded funds, where we BSE is having a star platform where mutual funds can be bought and sold. ETFs, very 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 important. As an investor, you can try ETFs, exchange traded funds, and please do your homework before investing in any of the investing tool which you are going to invest. ETF, exchange traded funds, please do your homework, where you can investing in passive funds such as Sensex funds or index funds. SME, small and medium enterprises platform, is also there. This is the need of the hour. BSE startup, just we have started up this platform for these startups. Around 7 companies are just listed. This is the BSE Direct, where you can investing in government treasuries, government securities and treasury bills through BSE Direct. This is a guaranteed by Government of India safe investment product. You can invest in treasury bills, government securities through this BSE Direct, where you get absolute return in investing in these type of government securities and treasury bills. Very very important is the compliant. Sir, I have not traded, but I have received, my broker has called me, I have traded, I don't have any proof. You need to, if you are having any complaint, you need to update in scores.gov.in, register yourself with email ID and mobile number. Very very easy. Login to www.scores.gov.in, register your complaint with valid documents, contract note, e-contract note, statement of account, both running account and demat account, everything needs to be submitted here, and then your complaint number will be generated, will be sent to your registered mobile number and email ID, where you can have track your status of the complaint from your home. Then next goes for the arbitration or IGRC, and award and the complaint gets closed. Investor grievance redressal mechanism, it is done. Complaint against the companies or brokers or the authorized persons. IGRC we are having in all the 24 cities across India, all the capitals. In state capitals we are having, in Chennai we are having, in Tenambet. BSE's IGRC and arbitration, where it is very fast, time bounding, award binding on parties, claim up to 10 lakhs, arbitration fees for the fee is exempt for the investors. If a exchange set aside the amount investor favor, the amount will be handed over to him. Advance payment of investor pending matters through IPF, Investor Protection Fund. Default, if a broker gets become default, IPF, Investor Protection Fund, will pay 15 lakhs according to the demat account which the shares are being having with the default broker. This is the website where you can have it, see the latest update. This is the most popular website in capital market, where you can get all the details, your trade information, like price, high, volume, low, close, everything has been seen. Corporate information, very very important, quarterly results, half yearly results, shareholding patterns which are listed in the BSE can be seen in this platform. Real time corporate announcements like bonus, dividend, etc. Because why we are, I am telling this, is before giving it to the media, any company has to submit to the exchanges and SEBI so you can get the corporate announcements real time before in the media. BSC Plus, it's a platform. You can have your valuation of your portfolio. It's just a watch list. You can have a look over your investments. You can have it, and you can have more data for you. Trade verification is available. You can cross-check the trades which are being executed with your broker in BSC website also. Now we are already having in mobile tablets. You can have BSCindia.com. You can download BSC website. You can have your real-time rates seen through mobile apps and tablets also. Thank you. Any doubts, you can contact here.
Thank you, Badri sir, for a wonderful overview presentation. So, investors, this is a very important mandatory thing to you all before you invest, because we have to look certain things of characters we have to follow. So, one thing is how to choose the investments. Another one thing, what are the asset classes we have to know well. Another one thing, what are the grievances sectors are there. So, if you have any grievances related things, you have to raise your complaints based on the guidance. Okay. So, hope you have really enjoy and get a lot of information about the financial market and its operations. Thank you, Badri sir, for all of this question. This video will be uploaded in YouTube. So if you have a look, you have to subscribe to the YouTube channel and then you can view the complete videos. Okay? Thank you. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.